Hey, this is Corey with Palmetto Battery Pros. Today we are going to be doing a lithium conversion on a 2010 Club Car Precedent. The first tip that I'm gonna give you is to always, before you start removing batteries or disconnecting anything, go ahead and take a photo of your battery tray with the batteries in it and hooked up. That way you have a reference if you need to come back and check those photos to make sure you're hooking everything up properly, especially it's very important when it comes to hooking up your 12 volt accessories. All right, we have the battery tray completely cleaned out and we are ready for the battery. And before we install the battery, I'm going to show you what all comes with the installation kit for your RoyPow battery. First of all, you'll get a mounting bracket. This is the Club Car mounting bracket. We'll be putting that in a minute. You get a charger user manual along with your charger. This is a lithium iron phosphate charger. Heavy duty 110 cord. You have your onboard charger mount. So you will be mounting this charger on board using this connection piece in the middle. Mounting hardware, a voltage meter that will be mounted on the dash, and a user's manual. And of course, it will come with the RoyPow battery. We will be installing this battery. This is a 51 volt, 56 amp hour battery. It has a 20 to 30 mile runtime per charge. It has the same footprint as the 105. So if you're installing a 105 in your cart, the process is exactly the same.
I'm ready to install the battery. I went ahead and put the mounting bracket inside the battery tray. And now I'm gonna be setting the battery in there. And I'm just gonna make sure that everything is lined up properly before I drill it into place. And I wanna make sure that I'm giving myself room. So I wanna slide it as far forward as I can to give as much room on this side for the controller. Make sure that you have the holes on the battery lined up with the holes on the mounting bracket. Once you have it in a good place, you can go ahead and secure the mounting bracket. Let's see if you can see down in there. Yeah, you can go ahead and mount the mounting bracket down to the battery tray, and then the battery's ready to be secured. When you put the battery in, you're gonna have plenty of space left over. I like to put the battery on the passenger side with the terminals facing into the middle so I have enough room for all my cables. And in the extra space, I'm gonna be mounting the onboard charger. All right, so now we're gonna go ahead and secure the mounting bracket down to the battery tray. It comes with mounting bolts. I usually, to make save time, and I feel it's a little stronger, I use self-tapping screws and just screw it down in there. Put the battery in, lining up the holes on the mount. All right, I've got all four of my mounting bolts started. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and tighten them down and this battery will be secure. This battery is now secured down to the cart. Very solid installation. The mounting bracket definitely makes it very secure, very safe. All right, so I went ahead and took the dash off to put the voltage meter on. Basically, first I removed the old voltage meter, which is kind of small in comparison to the RoyPow voltage meter. So once I took the old voltage meter out, I grabbed the RoyPow
voltage meter, and I measured the back end, and then I made a crude template out of just a piece of paper.
The template, I put it to the far right of the existing hole, and I just widened it. So the existing hole was in the upper left of my template. So it actually fits pretty tight in there, but you know, you don't want to extend it past this lip. Then next I'm gonna run the voltage meter wire up under the dash and around to the battery bank. And that meter wire plugs in to this RS485 port on the battery. Now I like to just run mine underneath the cart. It saves a lot of time and energy going up underneath and through, and I feel like you can run it down there with no problems as long as you zip tie it up securely and keep it away from the pedal linkages. All right, once I plugged it in, I'm gonna test it by turning on the battery, holding the power switch down for about 4 seconds, and then my voltage meter comes on. This is a 12 volt reducer. It has two wires coming in, which would be your red and black, and it has two wires coming out, which is your yellow and black. So you have 48 volts going in, and you have 12 volts coming out, so you don't damage any of your 12 volt accessories. In this car's case, the lights are the only 12 volt accessories, so we're gonna be hooking those up now. I will be running wires, crimping some wires to the battery pack from my input to my battery pack, and then I'll be hooking the lights up to the output wires. So here's what I have hooked up to my terminals. I have my positive and negative for my 12 volt reducer. I have my main positive. I have my main negative. And I also went ahead and installed the onboard plug for the charger. So this charger will mount onboard, and I'll show you that in just 1 second. So I went ahead and mounted the charger in this open space right here. This is about the best space to put it, so you don't hit anything on the bottom if you're using self-tapping screws like I did. Okay, we have everything hooked up and installed. This card is good to go. I did want to talk to you about the lights. So you should have had this blue wire on your lead acid batteries. It should have been hooked to two of your batteries, giving you 16 volts. What I did was I took that off and ran it directly to the 12 volt reducer. And your negative runs out of the wire that goes back to the tail lights, and you'll see the ground coming off of that. I have them zip tied, but the ground and that blue wire run to your 12 volt reducer. All right, now that I have everything installed properly and my lights are ran to the 12 volt reducer, I'm gonna go ahead and make sure that the charger is operating properly. So I went ahead and ran a 110 extension cord into the battery tray and ran it directly to the charger. The charger kicked on, and you can also see that it's charging by the voltage meter, and you can also hear the fan running on the charger, so you know it's charging up. So it's a pretty simple install on this model. You do not have to remove the OBC unless you are using the charging port, and we will get into that later. I should post another video
on the charging ports here coming up soon. So if you have any questions, leave a comment below and I will try to answer any questions you may have. It's a pretty straightforward installation, and this customer will really enjoy this RoyPow battery. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.